I'm France Cordova, and with this video cast, we continue our series of conversations with Purdue's astronaut alumni. As you know, the university's engagement with flight predates Amelia Earhart's arrival on campus. In 1935, Amelia joined Purdue's faculty, serving as a counselor in the study of careers for women and an advisor in aeronautics. The following year, she acquired a new Lockheed Electra airplane, which she called her flying laboratory. It was purchased with funds from the Purdue Research Foundation. And with her new airplane, Amelia began planning a flight around the world. 40 years later, in 1975, Janice Voss graduated from Purdue with a degree in engineering science and a flight plan of her own. Today, a NASA veteran of 5 space flights, Dr. Voss has logged more than 49 days in space, traveling 18.8 million miles in 779 Earth orbits. Listen to what Janice has to say about her Purdue experience.
The reason I picked Purdue is because they were head and shoulders the friendliest of the universities. They offered me a mentor. They sent me all kinds of information about the dorms and the life in addition to the curriculum. And I just thought, wow, this is a place that I would be at home. When I was a freshman, I came out, I love school. I do very well in school. And of course, grade school, high school, I'm a straight A student, right? I get to Purdue, I'm enrolled in their honors physics class, freshman class, get my first test back. There's a big 60 on the top, right? There's also a big A, but you know, 60, I've never gotten a 60 in my entire life. There is no way that I should ever get a 60 on a test, right? I head down to freshman engineering in a panic. I'm gonna flunk out of this university. You know, they didn't laugh in my face. They are very supportive. They offered me a mentor if I wanted one, and very nicely calmed me down, you know, helped me through it. And it was easy. I never felt like, you know, I was being sidelined or being patronized or anything. It was just whatever I needed, they were there. So I'm back there once or twice a year, heavily talking to women engineering students, which is an area, of course, I can really be a mentor for, but also other programs of different sorts. What really excites me about Purdue right now today is the new president, that we have France Cordova, who has a PhD in astrophysics, which I think is going to be spectacular for the university. I enjoy the personal part of it, but I really am proud of the technical excellence at Purdue, and I think having a PhD astrophysicist at the top of the university really highlights that and will attract even more of the brightest students. And I'm looking forward to having a chance to meet her again. Right now, the future of space exploration is heading towards Moon and Mars. It'll probably take longer, as it usually does, because funding's always a challenge. But that's a relatively near-term goal. I would easily think the generation of undergraduate students today can expect to be on Mars before their career ends. I think that would be just lovely. I remember the day I was selected as an astronaut, I was actually on travel. So the next morning, I'm sitting in a rental car space waiting for the bus to go to the airport. And I looked up, and there's the moon, and I remember thinking, I'm going to be working with people that walked on the moon. Can you imagine some student looking at me and saying, I'm going to be working with people that walked on Mars? I mean, that's just amazing.
Janice exemplifies Purdue's commitment to engagement, discovery, and learning. Purdue will recommit itself to pursuing those themes, which were part of our last 6-year strategic plan, as we draft the plan that will guide our next several years.